You have received a project report of the project that I have recently involved in. Please write your name on top of it. This is because I believe a lot of sales happen through way of references, okay? And this is the largest collection of people that I know I can talk to at any given time. Do you know why Genghis Khan rode across the plains of Central Asia along with his army conquering tribe of tribe? Do you know why Alexander, or Sikandar as we call him, marched from Macedonia till the Hindu Kush mountains and was driven back to wherever he belonged to? It was only for land. As humans, we have this inherent primeval instinct to own land as much as we can. It does not matter if it is a 30-40 site or a kingdom which spans continents. As humans, we need to own land. We need to call some part of land as our own. That is one of the reasons why we invest in land, we buy land, right? What are the other reasons that we buy land? Land, as we all know, has got one very good attribute to it. It is called positive intrinsic value. What that means is, land which you have purchased today was cheaper yesterday. And land which you have today is going to be costlier tomorrow. So there is always a positive graph to land. It doesn't matter if the graph is a little shallow in days of difficulties, but it is always an upflowing graph. What that also means is, land is a very good instrument to invest. If you have some money, put it in land, wait for some time, you'll get bigger returns. What that means is, land is a good vehicle of capital appreciation and capital security, both. Apart from this, land is also a great way to diversify your portfolio. If you have invested in mutual funds, if you have been playing in the stock exchange, if you have been successful with all that, land is also a great place to invest your money, right? As Indians, because of these qualities, we look to invest whatever hard-earned money that we have, little or more, okay, into buying land. For example, if we have a newborn in the family, iske naam se kuch leke rakhenge, right? When he or she grows up, it will support him or her for higher studies or whatever, right? We also buy land for, say for example, if it is a young professional, okay? This professional thinks that investing in land keeping will be a good return for him when he retires. These are the ways why, you know, reasons why we need to invest in land. But having said that, what are the things that you need to be looking at to invest in land? What are the pointers that decide whether this investment in land is a good one or bad, right? So, of all the qualities, if we talk of broadly, the first three attributes that we need to look at before investing in land is location, location, and location. These are the first three. Location in the terms, the first location is the micro level. Whenever you go to a place to visit, the first thing is, where are you standing? Is it a level land or is it a slope land? How do you feel the soil is, right? Whether if tomorrow there is a rain, you don't want your entire land which you have purchased to be flooded, right? This is something you look at. The second location is, what is happening in the immediate vicinities? How far is your police station? How far is your railway station, the bus stand, the school? These are the things that you need to look at. The third location means, where is your land that you're purchasing located geographically? Okay? Having said this, the land that I'm talking of, Primum Webstratum Ventures, is located in the heart of Chikbalapur. 0.8 kilometers to the left is the national highway, 0.8 kilometers to the right is the state highway. From where the location is, it is 1.5 kilometers from the railway station. Right in front of the land is a educational institution which we all know, BGS Global Institute. Okay? Right in front is an 80 feet road, right opposite to the site is a Kirana store. The surroundings are already populated. So location, location, location. Apart from location, we need to look at the due diligence, legal due diligence. Since I'm not an expert in the legal due diligence, I had handed over the part of the job to Prasanna, the legal in the chapter. And after having scrutinized 50 years of the paper, he said something which in his term probably means something big. He said, the land is satisfactory and marketable. Okay? Anybody who wants to know a little more of it, I'll be willing to furnish the legal documents for further scrutiny. Then we also need to look at the interest the administration of the government has in developing that part of the land. We all know that North Bangalore is the hotbed of investment nowadays, right? You can go through the project report that I've given. There are a lot of other instances, a lot of examples why investing in North Bangalore is a great opportunity to do. If you can go to the last page, okay, of the project report that I've given, there's a case study that I mentioned in which I've kept two things very constant. I've kept the land developer constant and I've kept the project launch date constant. For example, this is a comparison between an investment in an apartment and in land. You can go through this probably in leisure, but what it basically says is, if you have invested the same amount of money at the same date, 10 years later, a land gives you a lot higher appreciation, a lot more value in return. Now, before I go to my asks, I want to give you my gifts. Akash Anil, DGFAPS, he is the director of DGFAPS Prime Private Limited and Mac Industries. Guru Raj Rao, who is the MD of Arpita Aromatics. Bhanu Murthy, who is the head of marketing Krisha Properties. Syed Nizam, who is the head of SJ Switchgears. Shekhar Chalje, the CEO of Mercedes Benz. I believe I have 30 more seconds. Right. So here is what I want you to do. I want you to go to the last page, fill in your name. There are a few asks that I require from you. These are the referrals that I want you to work out for me. Okay. As few or as many names as you can. Okay. First column is the contact here. Real estate consultants, chartered accountants, realty, investment, hedge managers. The second is the direct owners. Like I told you, we invest in land because we have pride in investing in land, right? I want you to come up with a few names who would be directly willing to buy land, right? This page is what you could give back to me in the coming couple of weeks. Thank you.
Thank you.